You must read the operator manual that came with your product for all the warnings and cautions for the AF50 bandsaw. The operator manual will also cover each step in full detail. Current versions can be downloaded from Tormach.com. Once you've taken the AF50 bandsaw off the pallet, you must verify that it's approximately level. This will help with things like coolant flow, but does not impact the machine performance. Find the coolant tank inside the machine stand. Remove all the parts, which include the coolant screen, the coolant tube, and the roller. Place the tank with its lid back underneath the stand. Then connect the coolant tube to the port below the machine base, while the other end sits on the lid of the tank. Put the coolant screen in the indent on the machine base. Install and hand tighten the three blade tensioner handles. The rear cage is secured for shipment. Remove the two bolts. To install the rear roller, install the two spacers on either end of the roller posts. Insert one end into the frame, then squeeze the spring-loaded post in and slide it into the other end. Open the fixed jaw by turning the handle counterclockwise until you have sufficient clearance for your square. Place the square on the base casting. If it is not square with the blade, then loosen the two fixed jaw bolts and align it with the square and retighten. Place the square on the base casting, slide it over the infeed table to check the height. Adjust the back leg until both are at the same height. Slide the rear jaw up to the fixed jaw and check if they're square against each other. If they are not, loosen the four bolts and adjust the infeed table to match. Your site's air pressure needs to be between 90 and 120 psi. Tormach recommends using a compressed air dryer, desiccator, or filter between the air compressor and the machine. The AF50 bandsaw is provided with a filter regulator lubricator. You must also lubricate the air with air tool oil. Connect your site's air line to the input port on the FRL. You must verify that the proximity sensors are correctly installed and that their wiring is free of knots or obstructions. Use a metal shim to verify that each proximity sensor has a gap of between 20 and 30 thousandths of an inch, or 0.55 to 0.75 millimeters. Your bandsaw will arrive with one saw blade installed, but you must make sure it is set to the correct tension. Turn the tensioner until the tension is at 100 kilograms. Connect the bandsaw's power cable to a verified electric service. Turn the main disconnect switch to on. Rotate the emergency stop button one corner turn clockwise to release it. Verify that the lights on the control board panel come on. Adjust the hydraulic cylinder to get the desired drop speed. Push the emergency stop button to lock it into the disabled position. Turn the main disconnect switch to off, which disconnects power from the machine. At this point, you've successfully verified the installation of your AF50 bandsaw. If you have any issues, please refer to your manual or contact Tormach customer support at support@tormach.com.